Now this is when this happens, you told me when this happens at a table, everybody around that table wants it to happen at their table too.
It's like a chain reaction. What happens is one person sees it and they just say, oh, I want that. Yeah. What is that? I want that.
Now
and
what is happening here?
See, that's the Bunsen burner. That's
what is this?
The little butane burner.
Look
there.
At this.
What it does is we actually heat up the water and we put it on for 4 minutes. And when the water reaches a certain temperature, it starts to bubble. And when it bubbles, that's when we take the top and we connect it on to the siphon itself.
So she actually has a timer here.
Right.
So it's down to the second.
Yeah, well, because brewing, and in brewing coffee, you don't want to brew it too light and you don't want to over extract it. So there's a certain period of time in the brewing process where you're releasing a lot of the sugars and all the good flavors that are coming out of the coffee. And for a siphon, at that particular cut, it's 4 minutes exactly. So that's how we time it.
Okay, there's the grape-sized. Oh my gosh. Look at this. Now what are you doing? These are bubbles just percolating up. Oh, look what's happening up here. The water is going from the lower globe up to the top. Now, is that brewing the coffee right now? Is that what's
happening? It is. And what we're going to do is we're just going to incorporate the grounds.
Oh, wow. Greg, come over here a minute and talk to us.
This is quite a science, huh?
Yeah, this is very exciting just watching this.
Now, what causes it not to come back down into the bowl?
Right there, you see in the middle, there's a spring and it's holding down a cloth filter over the top. Now, what happens is the fire is not actually percolating the coffee, it's the steam. And there takes a certain amount of steam pressure to actually raise that spring to allow the steam to come through. And that steam is approximately 200 degrees percolating up there. So it actually gives an even temperature extraction because the steam is the part that's percolating the coffee.
Now, what is this called again, this whole?
This is called a siphon coffee.
A siphon coffee, and
right.
This was invented by the
Japanese?
How many years ago?
Hundreds of years ago. And this particular method here is probably our most popular coffee purchased here. Once one goes to a table, then all the other tables just start ordering after that.
So you're, how do you know? What are you waiting on now, Grace?
Well, we've got a timer. So when it gets down to about a minute 20 is when you give a final blast of the flame and then you turn it off. And as soon as the temperature starts to drop, then it comes out of the cylinder and back into the bowl.
Wow.
So we've got about 40 seconds left at this point.
I have never concentrated this much before on coffee being brewed, but it's a whole art form, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, this is where you take from just having a cup of coffee to having a coffee experience. So it's about 1 minute left in the process.
Oh, wait a minute, there it comes. Okay, there comes, now this is the freshly brewed coffee ready to drink, right?
Exactly, the vacuum pressure from the bottom actually sucks the coffee down, right.
So this is all physics or?
Chemistry and physics, right, the movement, yeah.
Wow, the top part goes off, it all fits. It all fits together.
There you go.
And here comes the coffee.
Can't wait. Do we just tip?
Boy, this better taste good after all of this.
I'm sure.
Wow, look how she's pouring it. Look at I love the whole look of the little coffee pot there. Wow. This is great. Okay, breakfast has arrived. The coffee has cooled down. Bon appetit. And you didn't even want to put any sugar or cream in it because you wanted the pure coffee.
I wanted to taste it.
Yeah. What does it taste like?
Yeah. It tastes wonderful and clean and delicious and rich.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And how much better is the experience because you actually saw it being brewed at your table?
Oh, I appreciate the process as much as the coffee, yeah.
You like the chemistry of it, don't you?
I do like the chemistry of it, yeah.
Well, there is chemistry involved.
Yeah, definitely. It's just a matter of watching it, how it's being processed, and your appreciation for what you're going through really comes out, and your cup of coffee, it's just like at home when you prepare your food, the detail you go through, there's an appreciation for it there. We go through a lot to prepare coffee here to make it that culinary experience.